Good morning, dear children. We have finished our portions. So today, as informed earlier, today onwards we can start revision. Okay. First we can revise the lesson light. That is actually our last chapter. Okay. Then all of you having the notes. Okay. You have to take the textbook also. Okay. First we can revise the exercise questions. Okay. Okay, first you have to choose the correct options. Okay, the first question is, the surface of a stone appears dull because it, you have to choose the correct answer. The surface of a stone appears dull because it, what is the answer actually? It diffuses light. Diffuses light means it throws light in different direction. That is actually called the diffuse. Okay. The because the stone that throws light in different directions, that is why the surface of stone appears dull. Okay, that is the answer. The surface of a stone appears dull because it diffuses light, because it throws light in different directions. That is why the surface of a stone appears dull. Okay, all of you got it? The next question is, the image formed by a plane mirror is, the image formed by a plane mirror. All of you know the image formed by the plane mirror is actually virtual and inverted. The image formed by the plane mirror is actually what? Virtual and inverse. Okay, the virtual and inverse. Listen to it. You see the first option, the virtual and upside down. Okay, actually it is not upside down. So daily you are looking the plane mirror. Actually it is what? Not upside down. It is erect actually. Listen to it. Then it is real and inverse. The second option is it is real and inverse. Actually the image formed by the plane mirror is not real. Actually it is inverse, but it is virtual. So that option is also wrong. Then actually it is inverse and straight. Okay, that is also wrong. So the correct option is it is virtual and inverse. Virtual and inverse. Virtual image, you know, it cannot be captured on a screen. That is actually the virtual image. Then inverse means what? It is laterally inverted. That is the right side appears as left and left side appears as right. So the image formed by a plane mirror is virtual and inverse. Okay, option, that is actually the correct option. Listen to it. And the next question is, the image formed by a convex mirror cannot be captured on a screen because it is not formed by, okay, the image formed by a convex mirror is cannot be captured on a screen because it is not formed by what? You know, the real images can be captured on a screen because it is formed by the actual reflected rays of light. Okay, that is why it is the real image. That image can be captured on a screen. Listen to it. That is actually, the real images are actually formed by concave mirror. Here the image formed by, why the image formed by convex mirror cannot be captured on a screen? You know, actually it is virtual image, you know, because it cannot be captured on a screen. The image formed by convex mirror cannot be captured on a screen because it is a virtual image. Because what? It is not formed by option A. First option is actually sunlight. It is wrong answer. Then bright light. Then white light is fourth option. You see the third option. Actually, it is the actual reflected rays of light. It is not formed by actual reflected rays of light. Okay. The image formed by convex mirror is not formed by what? Actual reflected rays of light. That is why it is a virtual image. So it cannot be captured on a screen. Listen to it. So the third option is the correct answer. Okay, it is not formed by actual reflected rays of light. Listen to it. The next question, fourth question is, a convex lens diffuses light. Okay, it does not actually diffuse light. Then it does diverges light. Actually, convex lens does not diverges light. Listen to it. then convex lens reflects light. Okay, that is also wrong. You see the third option, it converges light. Okay, no, convex lens which converges light, that is why the convex lens is called a converging lens. Okay, convex lens converges light, that is it. Here what will happen when light rays that passes through the convex lens, it converges to a particular point. So it converges light, isn't it? Here the convex lens converges light. Next, the fifth question is, a concave mirror is used by dentist because it can. Okay, you know, concave mirror, we already learned in the uses of concave mirror. Concave mirror is used by dentist. What is the reason actually? You see the first option, it reduces the size of an image. Then suppose if it reduces the image, how the dentist can clearly see the image of teeth? You know that thing. Okay, then it invades an image. No. Then diverge light rays. Concave mirror actually does not diverge light rays. See the third option, it magnify an image. Okay, actually the concave mirror magnifies the image. Then only the dentist can clearly see the image of tooth of patient. Listened it? So that is why the dentist uses concave mirror, because it magnifies the image, it enlarges the image. Okay, that is the size of the image is larger than the object. Listened it? Here, a concave mirror is used by dentist because it can magnify an image. That is the correct answer. Then an image formed by a concave lens is always, first is real, actually it is not real, then large. That is also wrong, then inverted. What is the correct answer actually? It is virtual. Okay, the image formed by a concave lens is actually virtual. The image formed by concave lens is what? Virtual. That cannot be captured on a screen. Isn't it? All of you got it? Next, we can tick the correct statements. Okay, true or false actually. First question is, a plane mirror produces regular reflection. You know, is true or false actually? It is true. You know, plane mirror is actually a smooth and polished surface. Actually, in the case of smooth and polished surface, the reflection taking place is actually a regular reflection. Okay, the reflection taking place is actually regular reflection. So the plane mirror produces a regular reflection is actually correct. It is true statement, isn't it? The next is, a plane mirror is used in compound microscope. Isn't it? A plane mirror is used in a compound microscope. That is actually true. It is used in compound microscope. Okay, plane mirror is actually used in compound microscope. Then a concave mirror is a spherical mirror. You know, actually, concave mirror is a part of what? A hollow sphere of glass. Okay, actually, concave mirror is a part of hollow sphere of glass. It is otherwise called the curved mirror. Okay, so the spherical concave mirror is actually a spherical mirror. Actually, it is true. Then the image formed by a convex mirror appears to be far away. The image formed by a convex mirror appears to be far away. Isn't it? Actually, it is false. Okay, the image formed by a convex mirror actually appears to be close. Okay, that is why it is used as a rear view mirror in vehicles. Listen to it. The image formed by a convex mirror appears to be far away. Actually, it is the wrong statement. It is false. Actually, it is appears to be close. Okay, then magnifying lens is actually a concave lens. Magnifying lens is actually what? A concave lens. Is it true or false actually? Magnifying lens is not the concave lens. Actually, it is the convex lens. Convex lens is a magnifying glass. Okay, magnifying lens. Convex lens is a magnifying lens. So, here the statement is actually false. Okay, the magnifying lens is actually a concave lens. Actually, it is the false statement. Actually, convex lens is used as a magnifying glass. or sorry magnifying lens. Okay, all of you got it? The next is answer the following questions in one sentence. You know, first question is how many colors are there in a spectrum of white light? Okay, how many colors are there in a spectrum of white light? Actually, how many colors are there? You know, these 7 colors. Okay, we observe starting from violet to red. Okay. Here the spectrum of white light actually consists of 7 colors. Okay, starting from violet to red. That is actually we observe. Okay, that is white light is consists of 7 colors. Okay, so how many colors are there in the spectrum of white light? Actually, it is 7 colors. Okay, the next question is, can the image formed on a plane mirror be captured on a piece of paper? Okay, can the image formed by a plane mirror be captured on a piece of paper? Okay, can you form the image formed by a plane mirror? Can you capture it on a piece of paper? No, the plane mirror, the image formed by plane mirror, you know, it is virtual. Virtual images cannot be captured on a screen. Isn't it? The virtual images cannot be captured on a screen. So the image formed by the plane mirror cannot be captured on a screen. Okay, or here a piece of paper. Okay, what is the answer? The image formed by plane mirror cannot be captured on a piece of paper. Okay, the next question is, why are concave and convex mirrors are called spherical mirrors? Okay, why are concave and convex mirrors are called spherical mirrors? Actually, concave and convex mirrors are portions or part of hollow sphere. Okay, both concave and convex mirrors are actually part of a hollow sphere of glass. Okay, that is why these mirrors are otherwise called curved mirrors. Both concave and convex mirrors are otherwise called what? Curved mirrors. Okay, that is why concave and convex mirrors are called spherical mirrors. Okay, because they are the part of a hollow sphere. Okay, concave and convex mirrors are actually part or portions of a hollow sphere of glass. Okay, that is why these mirrors are called what? Spherical mirrors. Listen it. The next question is, which surface of a concave mirror is silvered? Which surface of a concave mirror is silvered? In a concave mirror, actually, the reflecting surface is curved inward, you know. Okay, that is the inner surface is curved inward. That is actually the reflecting surface. Okay, and here the question is, which surface of concave mirror is silvered? Okay, actually, the outer surface of concave mirror is silvered. Okay, the outer surface of concave mirror is actually silvered and the reflection is taking from the inner surface. Okay, the outer surface of concave mirror is actually silvered. Have you got it? Okay, the next question. You know, describe the image formed by the rear view mirror fitted on a vehicle. We have to describe the image formed by rear view mirror fitted on a vehicle. You know, actually, which mirror is used as a rear view mirror in vehicle? Actually, it is what? Which type of mirror? Okay, convex mirror. Actually, convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror. Convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror. Then we have to describe the image formed by the concave mirror or the rear view mirror or the convex mirror. We have to describe the image formed by the rear view mirror or the convex mirror. You know, actually it is the size is very small. The size of the image is small. Okay, actually it is smaller than the object and it is upright. Okay, it is smaller than the object and it is upright and it covers a wide area. Okay, it covers what? Wide area. Okay, suppose when we look through the rear view mirror, actually we can see the back portions fully. So it covers the wide area. Okay, so the image formed by the rear view mirror is smaller than the object Actually, it covers wide area, smaller than the object, and it is upright, and it is and it covers wide area. It covers wide area. Okay. The image found by the rear view mirror is actually smaller than the object, then upright or erect, then it covers wide area. Okay, and due to this, this convex mirror is actually used as a rear view mirror in vehicles. Okay, so we have another question. Why convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror in vehicles? Why convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror in vehicles? Because it the image is smaller than object, then it is upright and it covers wide area, isn't it? Then the next question is, why it is not possible to capture an image formed by a convex mirror? Okay, why it is not possible to capture the image formed by a convex mirror? Why we cannot capture the image formed by a convex mirror? You know, only the real images can be captured. We can capture only the real images. The image formed by convex mirror is actually virtual image. So it cannot be captured on a sheet of paper, or it cannot be captured on any screen, isn't it? The image formed by convex mirror is actually, it is not real, it is a virtual image. You know, real images can only be captured, the virtual images cannot be captured. That is why it is not possible to capture the image formed by a convex mirror. Okay, because the image formed by convex mirror is not real, actually it is virtual image. Virtual images cannot be captured on a screen. Virtual images cannot be captured on a screen. That is why it is not possible to capture the image formed by a convex mirror. Okay. Okay, children, fourth and fifth Roman letters are remaining. That thing we can revise on next class. Okay, all of you study well. Okay, if any doubt, you can ask. Okay.